Hi everyone. Today we're going to go through how to set up the cloud storage account and cloud storage device in NovaBackup. In this case, I have NovaBackup installed, licensed, and kind of ready to roll. The first thing you need to do is go to Cloud Backup and go to a website that you basically just need to register here. This is going to be where you want the actual cloud data to reside. In this case, I'm just going to have it stay in the US. Your license key, your username, I mean your e first name, last name, then I'm going to put in email address. Then the password. This password is going to be used for, in this case, with this checkbox, I'm going to use the password as the encryption key for the data that's actually residing in the cloud. You can specify your own if you want to and not use that password. But in this case, I'm going to keep it that same password for the encryption key. And then I'll check the little checkbox saying I've read the EULA, as I've read it many times. And I'll do the create cloud account. What this is going to do on the back end, it's going to check to make sure that everything's set up, create the cloud storage for you, and basically attach it to your installation of Nova Backup. It should take maybe 30-ish or so seconds here. All right. Perfect, it's already done. I'll just minimize that. If I go into the device tab, it has a Nova Backup Cloud storage device right in here. At this point, you can go to the backup tab. I'll just create a new backup job. I'll just call it Cloud Backup. And you can choose whatever you want to choose for backup. In this case, I'm just going to choose, say, the users directory. I'll go to the backup to button. And then choose the cloud storage account or the cloud storage device that I want to go to. And then one of the more important things that you want to set here is if you go to settings, the maximum backup age. This maximum backup age is basically how long you want versions of files to be out on the cloud. So this is all about, like, say, if you have like an Excel document or something like that that changes every day. And you do a backup every day, this is going to be how many days back you can actually restore different versions of those files. It's always going to keep the last version of each file that you back up, unless you deselect it for backup. But in this case, the biggest question is, how do I roll back to a different version of the file? This is kind of that one thing that it kind of sets it apart of how long you can go back for different versions of files. So I'll click OK there. I'll save the backup job here. This is Cloud Backup. And then I will start a backup. And that's pretty much all there is. It's going to do a little bit of cleanup at the very beginning, saying, hey, I'm going to try to import stuff. Since it's a brand new installation, it's going to see if there's anything out there. It's going to take half a minute or something like that and realize, hey, this is a clean account, there's nothing to import. But this is really just to safeguard if you are have an installation from a different one and then are installing it on a new machine, that it grabs those files so it doesn't try to do a backup of things that you already have in the cloud. And that's really all there is for setting up the cloud device and getting a cloud backup to the cloud.